In every smartphone, there's one quiet workhorse that rarely gets the spotlight, the modem. It's the component that keeps you connected whether you're in the heart of the city or on a quiet country road. But what happens when Apple decides to take control of this critical piece of technology? I was able to get an exclusive tour of Apple's modem testing labs for a behind the scenes look at the creation of the C1. Apple's first in-house modem chip that could subtly reshape the mobile experience for Apple users going forward. Now, before we jump into the details of the C1, what even is a smartphone modem? Well, the modem is the component inside your phone that connects you to mobile data networks. Think of it as the bridge between your phone and the world. It translates signals from cell towers into data that lets you browse the web, stream videos, and make voice calls. The modem determines how fast and reliably your phone can access the internet. It handles everything from older 2G and 3G signals to the faster 4G LTE and 5G networks of today. Without a good modem, your phone might struggle with slow downloads, dropped calls, or unreliable connections, especially when you're on the move. In essence, the modem is crucial because it directly affects the overall performance of your device. A better modem means faster data speeds, more efficient power use, and smoother performance even when the network is crowded. This is why Apple's decision to design its own modem chip is such a big deal. It's about taking control of one of the most critical components of modern smartphones in a way that they did with the system on a chip on the iPhone, iPad, and Mac. So in a huge but very subtle announcement, in my opinion at least, Apple announced the iPhone 16e, and as part of that announcement was the introduction of the Apple C1 modem subsystem. For the first time ever, Apple is developing its own modem chip rather than relying on a vendor like Qualcomm, a supplier that has powered not only Apple's devices in the past, but also countless Android and Windows devices as well. Now, with the C1 at its core, the iPhone 16e is positioned as the most affordable member of the iPhone 16 family. And I say this seems like a subtle announcement because it feels like most of the attention is on the iPhone 16e itself, with many not realizing exactly what's happening before our eyes with the C1. Now, I mentioned I got a tour of Apple's labs to learn about the creation of the C1, which was incredibly eye-opening. I was led by a few familiar names, like Apple's Senior Vice President of Hardware Technologies, Johnny Cerugi, the VP of iPhone Product Marketing, Kyan Drance, and the VP of Wireless Software, Arun Matthias. And here's a few things that I learned. First, these labs are where Apple Silicon engineers work tirelessly, surrounded by cutting-edge equipment and advanced simulation tools. Before any physical chip is even manufactured, engineers use sophisticated and formal verification methods to predict how the chip will behave under various conditions. And these virtual tests are crucial as they help identify potential issues before the modem ever leaves the design stage. Once the first silicon samples arrive, the real work begins. In these state-of-the-art labs, engineers were subjecting the C1 modem to extreme real-world stress tests. I'm talking environmental chambers where the chip is exposed to temperatures far beyond what it would normally encounter, ensuring that it can operate reliably even in the harshest conditions. They simulate everything from the sweltering heat of a summer day to the bitter cold of a winter night. Durability is also key. Engineers run repeated tests, like simulating the pressing of the power button tens of thousands of times to verify that every component of the C1 will stand up to daily wear and tear, and that the modem will turn on and off instantly when needed. And then there's the network tests themselves. The chip is put through its paces under various simulated conditions, from the heavy data traffic of a packed stadium to the minimal signals of a remote rural area. These tests ensure that the modem not only performs well on paper, but truly delivers in the real world. Now, every step of this process is meticulously documented and analyzed, with teams collaborating closely to address any issues that arise. And this rigorous testing and verification is what gives Apple the confidence to say that the C1 modem is not just a prototype or beta, but rather a robust platform built for the future. The C1 modem is manufactured using a state-of-the-art process, using a 4-nanometer process for its baseband, and that's a term that refers to the core part of the modem responsible for processing data signals, and a 7-nanometer process for its transceiver, which handles sending and receiving radio signals. Now, in simple terms, these numbers, the 4-nanometer and 7-nanometer, indicate the size of the transistors on the chip. Smaller transistors mean more can fit on a chip, leading to better performance and power efficiency. And the result is that the iPhone 16e boasts up to 26 hours of video playback on a single charge, ensuring that your device lasts longer even during heavy usage. And in fact, It has the longest battery life of any 6.1 inch iPhone to date. Now, when it comes to compatibility and reliability, Apple didn't design the C1 in a bubble. It was rigorously tested with over 180 carriers across 55 countries. This extensive testing means that whether you're in a bustling metropolis or a remote village, the C1 modem is engineered to deliver reliable connectivity. And then there's what Apple is best at, because one of the most exciting aspects of the C1 modem is how it works hand in hand with Apple's custom A18 processor. This tight integration allows the modem and processor to communicate in real time. So for example, if your phone encounters a congested network, the A18 can signal the C1 to prioritize critical data packets. Maybe you just opened messages and you're trying to send a photo or video to someone, or maybe you're playing a game. The A18 can direct the C1 to prioritize what you're actively doing so that things don't feel like they're bogging down. Now, this dynamic traffic management not only improves your connection speed, but also makes your device feel incredibly responsive under heavy network loads. And this is where you start to see the real benefits of Apple making its own modem start coming into play. Now, beyond your cellular connection and better efficiency, the C1 modem comes with additional capabilities like custom GPS and satellite connectivity. So all those Apple satellite services like emergency SOS, roadside assistance, messages via satellite, and Find My will all work on the devices with the C1 like the iPhone 16e. Now, it's important to note that the first generation C1 modem does have one obvious limitation. It doesn't support millimeter wave 5G, which offers ultra high speeds that are mostly relegated to Verizon here in the US and is a forte of Qualcomm. I think this is probably part of the well-known Apple phased rollout, where we'll see even more powerful and efficient C2 and C3 subsystems that give us even more capabilities, overcoming current limitations sometime in the future. And speaking of the future, for years, Apple has been dependent on Qualcomm for its modem chips. And it's a relationship that not only incurred significant licensing fees and legal fees, but also meant that Apple had less control over one of its most critical components. With the C1 modem, Apple is poised to change that. By bringing modem technology in-house, Apple stands to reduce costs and gain complete control over its hardware integration, paving the way for a more unified and optimized ecosystem. The iPhone 16e with the new C1 modem is the first step in a long-term strategy. By launching this chip in an entry-level model, Apple can collect real-world feedback and refine the technology before rolling it out across more popular and premium devices. Experts predict that while this first generation may have some limitations, future iterations will continue to obviously improve and eventually maybe offer features like millimeter wave support and even more advanced AI-driven connectivity. Imagine a future where not only your iPhone, but also your iPad, Mac, and other Apple devices share the same highly optimized connectivity platform. The potential for improved performance, battery life, and seamless integration is enormous. I think Apple is laying groundwork for a future where every device is interconnected in a way that enhances both efficiency and user experience. Let me know what you think about the C1 down in the comments below, and I will meet you there for further discussion. Thanks for watching as always, guys. I appreciate your support. I'm Andrew Webbers, and I will catch you in the next video.